Okay, before we continue on with our first video of the day, I just want to say I taped one earlier, but once again, the camera didn't recognize it, and I'm starting to think maybe it was the file was too big, and as a result, it wouldn't recognize it because the file was too big. So I'm going to try something new starting here. Every two matches, or every game in any other video game, or every 15 minute videos, or anytime I feel like it, and that's where we're going to stop, and we're going to take a break. So, hopefully this should work out. Otherwise, this thing's going to get refreshed. I don't know how, but I'll figure out some way to do it. So, alright guys, enjoy the show.
WWE presents NXT.
Welcome everybody to NXT. We are live and sold out, and tonight our NXT Women's Champion will be decided. Yes, this is a spoiler. We have a NXT title women's title match, and we're going to find out which will be the first team to punch their ticket to the finals of the NXT Tag Team Championship Tournament. And you'll see the contestants of the NXT Women's Champion. Yep, it's the second match of the card. And I'm going to try to do something new here. Every two matches, we're going to stop. And then three or four, then break. Then main event, which is Derek Gibson versus the Sheamus. And then we'll continue on toward our true main event, which is the tag team tournament for the NXT Tag Team Championships. As Justin Bain takes on the Ascension takes on the Real Americans. And then we're going to decide which of the top half will move on to the tournament, which will kick off after Against all odds. And by the way, just to spoil, we did have a title change which was documented, but unfortunately got lost in the shuffle. As you can see, Rainbow Ridge finally has championship gold as Jed won the television title by pinning Lucky Jim, as Coach Hines got distracted by doing the Coach Hines choke slam on Albert Novak, and he was too distracted when Jed got the pin. So as a result, Rainbow Ridge has championship gold as well. So that means Team Dry Gulch don't have championship gold around their waist. But tonight, we're going to find out as the first two qualifying matches, as Mr. Wayne Deer of Team Dry Gulch will take on Zack Slaughter, the former ECW World Television Champion, here tonight. Here we go, guys. And we are live from the Bridgestone Arena in Nashville, Tennessee. How appropriate, because Fastlane is going to be taking place from Memphis. And okay, guys, I got to ask you. Should I change Wayne's entrance? Because I heard a few people complaining, saying that Wayne's entrance is too red smoking. So I am going to consider changing his entrance just a tad bit. But I'm not really sure. So we know one half of the equation. Brandon Washington will defend the title against Troy Dillon and the other one of these winners here. And here comes the former ECW television champion in Zack Slaughter. Zack Slaughter. By the way, tomorrow on Saturday, I will be filming Against All Odds, along with other games. So, here we go. And this match will be at Extreme Rules, by the way. I did not notice, there's a glitch right there. And so far, Wayne Deere has yet to show much for his efforts here in this match thus far. And he missed. Had Zach and Wayne Deere actually get a move in? Oh man. And here comes the offense. And nope, the tempo just changed. And once again he missed. Come on, Wayne. Drop kick to the head. A suplex by Wayne Deere. And here's a pin. Rope break! You gotta be kidding me. Uh-oh. It's coming. DDT. That's it. And I think that's gotta be it for. That's it for Wayne Deere. It looks like Zack Slaughter will be going to Against All Odds for his first shot at a world title. But coming up next, this is the second one of the last match before we take a quick break. And it's a big one. The NXT Women's Championship will be crowned. And don't forget, both Rainbow... Both... Frontierland... is in this match. But, of course, there's Natalya. Trying to get her gold. Of course, Natalya, who fought valiantly in that Extreme Rules match, which we thought was for unification, but it wasn't until AJ and Caitlyn tried it again, and this time it worked. Here we go. And here we go, guys. Let's listen in. Squeaky Jean. The Frontierland Divas. As Squeaky Jean makes her first match, first title match here tonight. and the people, and also some good news. Whoever don't get pinned, they'll be facing off for the Mike from LA 1 Women's Championship. And here comes Molly. It's Francisca Moncarma, my bad. Moncarma, you gotta be careful of the Moncarma attack. I can guarantee you that. And speaking of Molly Moonstone, here she comes. And here she comes. And hopefully she'll get Frontierland their second championship gold. But of course, Francesca and Natalia are going to do their best to prevent that from happening. And here it comes. And by the way, you guys want to see the... Oh, by the way, again, I'm happy that, don't get me wrong, Charlotte is talented, but I think it was time for her to drop the belt. And by the way, does that belt look familiar? Yep, since the NXT Women's title is pretty much like the same color design, I just went with the Divas belt. I know that may be lazy, but hey, that's best for business. Alright guys, this will be the last part before we take a quick break. Here we go. And don't forget, the television match was a fatal four-way as well, so whoever gets distracted will probably lose this match. And once again, trying to go for a foot to get her ready for the sharpshooter, but once again, there it goes. And once again, gets interrupted by Molly, by Molly Moonstone this time. Oh man. And once again, going for a pin, no count there. Oh man, a chair shot by Molly. Man, she really is another diva. And nice job, Natty. Doing the right thing. Thank you. And once again, Squeaky Dean stops. Wait a minute. Oh, Bassbuster interfered. And a two count by Francisco Von Karma. And Molly's dominate as... Uh-oh. It's a squeaky ending. And the match continues. Russian leg sweep. And Natalya breaks it up. And what? Once again, Natalya was dominating, and now Molly's getting it in Francesca. Once again, almost. And once again, another kick out. Wait a minute here. Is this it for Molly? The go home driver. And Frontierland gets the gold. Now Frontierland takes the lead. It's 2-1, which means Natalya and Molly Moonstone get the mic from LA1 Women's Title match instead. So Frontierland is celebrating. But for Rainbow Ridge, that means they gotta try harder and get another gold. And as for the women's division, that is huge for Frontierland to get the win. And you gotta feel bad for Francesca Von Karma. She did a great job. But in the end, Frontierland gets retribution. As for the first time, they have a women's title belt. And I'll be right back, guys. And we're back, ladies and gentlemen. If you guys saw that beat up for a split second, Squeaky Jean is the first ever NXT Women's Champion. And now... time for me to go toe-to-toe with one member of the Shield before I face Brock Lesnar. And that is, of course, Fandango, whose t-shirt I have in my collection. Why did you change your theme? This one is clearly better. It is better. And speaking of themes that are awesome, here comes Dolph's theme, who's done it. Okay, you've seen my entrance 11 kabillion times already. So tomorrow morning, which is actually tomorrow, actually is going to be here in 3 minutes, so... So we're going to start off with a very early morning California Adventure video because let's be honest, I have never filmed California Adventure early in the morning. And plus this will give me the chance to show you guys a bunch of closed off. Close Ghirardelli, which that's my goal is tonight is to get there pretty early so I can get a fast pass for the sing-along, so that is my goal for tomorrow. Well, in 60 seconds it'll be here. Will be here, so yeah. So here we go. So once again, if you guys just joined in, I don't know why. Yeah, from now on, guys, unless I get an iPod situation settled, I'll be taking breaks in between because I filmed one earlier and the thing just didn't show up and I'm starting to think maybe the file was too big, so I'm gonna stop and just use the video editor that I use to edit them all together so that way I can upload it to YouTube. And I may have hit the ref. Okay, oh, now it's midnight. I was gonna say, Jen, it should have been midnight by now, but oh, there it is. Wait. Oh. Corner finisher. Bring it on. Here it comes. Sorry, Fandango. Spear! That was easy. That was easy. Next match, please. Now, what match is this? Oh, R-Truth versus Lester Buchek, which we're going to come make an announcement against all odds. Lester Buchek will get his title, will defend his United States Championship against Michael Taylor. R-Truth and Buster Houston. And Buster Houston in a steel cage. So this is the R-Truth and Lester Buchek's first matchup against each other here. And here comes the United States champion. Lester Buchek, the very first person to successfully cash in the Zachman 18 championship. And as a result, he cashed it on The Miz for the... for the United States. Oh, don't you dare, don't you dare, don't you dare, don't you dare, don't you dare. Are the United States Championship? At Lester Buchek. So as a result tonight, guys, so tonight, can Art... yeah, Lester Buchek beat The Miz in his first 10. Yeah, Lester Buchek's a two-time... a two-time, because he lost the title to The Miz, only to have him win it back. And as for Night of Champions, the kickoff match, I am leaning towards either the television title getting to be the match or the World Tag Team titles. So I want to hear some credible feedback here. Which match should be the kickoff? Comments below. And don't say WWE tag titles, because I'll be honest, that matchup's going to be coming soon, so yeah. So yeah, this will be the last set of videos I'll be working on. Then tomorrow I can get ready for tomorrow. And we're going to do a quick video in a California Adventure before we actually get started. And don't worry, Freeze the Night will happen sometime down the road. Nope, nice try, R-Truth. Oh man, the little Jimmy. I don't know what he calls it now. Oh, rope break. Wait, is Lester bleeding? And another rope break. No, he's not bleeding. Oh, actually, change of plans. It looks like we're gonna announce another match at Against All Odds. Woodrow Ambrose will defend the WCW Hardcore title against Dallas Reddick, Ryan Hitchcock, and you know what, actually, our main event, we'll have him, fourth person, announced on, in a battle royal, to determine who will be the fourth person to enter that tournament, and R-Truth has pinned the United States champion. Wait a minute, oh! I've got some bad news. I want it as well. Okay, it looks like we may have a third match equation here. Bad News Barrett versus R-Truth for the ECW World Television title? I don't know, and I'll see you guys in a little bit. Okay, guys, we are back. After bit of a weird confrontation between Bad News Barrett and R-Truth. So probably when I'm having lunch at the park, I will make the final decision. But coming up next is one of our two main events, Derek Gibson versus Sheamus. And here comes the NXT champion. And Derek Gibson getting ready for his match here. And boy, this could be a big opportunity here for Derek Gibson. He'll be taking on Sheamus. Of course, in real life, Kevin Owens is the new NXT champion. And here comes probably the most hilarious moment here. Look at the title card. Look at the name card. Take a look. Yep, Sheamus is our jobber champion. Which I think he won in the last, live special, I think. I gotta take a look at that. Look at Shane, man. Look at, oh, poor Derek, man. He is not prepared for this at all. Of course, Derek Gibson defeated Big E to win a title opportunity in that NXT Championship tournament. And boy, this could be huge for Sheamus. Should Sheamus win this, he could get that jobber belt off of him, and this will be a footnote in his career. And I just realized he's the first Irish-born jobber champion, so congratulations, Sheamus. Man, Derek is having some serious issues here. Derek, wait a minute. Oh my god. White noise! Derek. Oh, what the? Oh my god! You gotta be kidding me! He countered the bro kick. How did he counter the bro kick? Here it comes. Not the bro kick. That's it. Sheamus, kiss that jobber championship goodbye. You may be the number one contender for the NXT championship. Oh, wait a minute. I just got informed by William Regal that Sheamus will get the jobber belt off of him. That the NXT number one contender match could be competed in a backstage brawl at Against All Odds. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Another match for Against All Odds. So a number one contender's backstage brawl will determine the number one contender for Derek Gibson. But never mind that, ladies and gentlemen. Our main event the first of our two semifinal matches. Who will make it here? Will it be the Ascension or will it be the Real Americans? So here we go. Let's see what the matchup is here. A steel cage? No. I don't like that stipulation. Okay, let's see. Tornado Tag Team Ladder. Okay, I like that, but not a ladder. Okay, let's see what this stipulation is. Another Tornado Tag Team Ladder. Jeez, what is going on? By the way, look at the teams. By the way, before we continue on here, Justin Bain and the Ascension crushed the rest of Peace Bros, who are now the number one contender for the Mike from LA One World Tag Team titles, as Cesaro Swagger destroyed Virgil and $1 Million Corporation. Okay, let's see what stipulation this is. Tornado Tag. Okay, this is good. Alright, here we go. So this means this is the even the playing field. And also the European title match will be determined in Hell in a Cell. I know what people are thinking. Michael, how can you put a Hell in a Cell and a steel cage in the same one? Well, one is a video game, so who gives a crap? And here we go, guys. Here come the Ascension. And here come the Real Americans. Mine is Zeb Coulter. Now this is gonna be a battle that we all want to see here. The Ascension taking on the Real Americans. This is the first big test for the Ascension as a tag team. Here we go. And oh, good luck, Justin. You got Cesaro, a former United States and European champion. And look at this, the Ascension, there are, right now, as Justin Bane is taking care of Cesaro and Nort Newby, a former television champion, while Justin Bane, who hasn't won a title yet here in the WWE, he is trying to get his footing here, and look at this, now the Ascension of, well, minus Jack Swagger. Wait a minute. Cesaro, what are you doing? Cesaro. There we go. Here it is. Feeling the bane. Rope break. Oh, that may have been a close call for the real Americans. That could have been it for the real Americans' hopes of becoming tag team titles. And there goes the ref. And nice, thank you, Cesar. Thank you, North Newbie. And the Ascension move on. The Ascension just booked their ticket. That's booked their ticket to the NXT Tag Team Final. Alright guys, thank you for joining me for NXT. See you next time. Good night.